Hey, don't, man. Dang it.
This is where we're staying, Chris. South of Cardi. That's the kitchen.
We didn't see it.
There's the balcony up to the bedroom. There's two queen size beds and a bathroom up there. And downstairs. That's the laundry closet door right there. Washer dryer. This is the living room. Fireplace.
Tell
you what, I've been looking through everything that's ever been here. Yeah.
What's a
Schwana?
That movie
schedule and then this. This is the way the counter is. Kind of a bar style.
Somebody made that.
There's the dining room where I just was taking a picture from. Double sliding glass doors.
Get the women under control.
Tall ceiling. And there's a bedroom. Big bedroom right back there. With a bathroom.
He was all alone though.
Who was? Why?
He said it was so much fun down there.
Big bedroom in here. Bathroom.
Wall on sled number 16 is in 8th position. The team of Walker and Schultz on sled number 46 is in 9th. Tom Bozak on sled number 77 is 10th. Gay Bunky on sled number 74 is in 11th. Diamond Fountain Racing on sled number 65 is in 12th. Vincent and Kuczynski on sled number 20 is in the 13th position. Gary Newton and Scott DeZerka on sled number 45 is 14th. Fountain and Fountain on sled number 00 is in the 15th position. Sled number 18, ridden by Mr. Perky, is in the 16th position. Bad Frog Racing, Kurtz and Hoos, is in the 17th position. Artuso and Mayer on sled number 24 is in the 18th position. Sled number 12, ridden by Lito and Blackwell, is in the 19th position. Scott Majiak and Haynes on sled number 26 is in the 20th starting position. Lukowski and St. John on sled number 42 is in the 21st position. Mike Gentz on sled number 14 is in the 22nd position. Nelson and Nelson Racing on sled number 99 is in the 23rd position. Kip Miller and Ransom on sled number 66 is 24th. Prunick and Kolbus on sled number 75 is in the 25th position. Tarvin and Abelson on sled number 39 is 26th. McSwain and Dupuis on sled number 30 is in 27th position. Schmidt and Schmidt, the driver, is on sled number 47, starting
28. Faceless driver Scott Larson, the one out there on the Polaris with the Woody's flag in the back. He's radio equipped and he's listening for the flagman Roger Brett to give him the command to pull off, and the guys will go green.
Thank you.
have made it. Or do we have it?
Russ was currently in second place. it does help the drivers keep their hands warm. Complete, and if the race was to end right now, the Troy DeWald and Scott Crickey team have two laps on the rest of the field, so that means they get 2 points that the rest of the field would not get. So we'll see how many more laps they can gain on the field.
Missed him when he came by.
Looks like you might even not even make it around and have to pull that sled off the track. Sled number 55 is in third. He's not in second and third. That would be a difficult thing to do. 43 is in fourth. 21 is in fifth. 74 is in sixth. 45 is in seventh. 46 is in eighth. 26 is in ninth.
This is a major points race today, too.
They bunch up good as they come through three and four. You'll notice Tim is right on the back door. Done before, and that's how you got to do it. You got to be running fast enough to be ahead of the leader on the racetrack. Let the caution help you. They don't have to hang their head. The whole field is possible. 60 seconds. Are you all doing the driving on 60 seconds? Not most of these seconds, only 70 seconds. Third place will be 5%. Fourth place, 4-16. Is Matty Collins, Greg Barton, in the front? Gary Newton is at 7, Lee Cash is at 8, and the old man, Carl Schwartz, on sled number 46 is in 9th, and the major runner is on the part of Tom Bozak to get back a lap. And right now, he's done it. Tom is leading him. We went to a yellow, and that would give Tom a free pass all over the round. That would put Tom back. I have to say, he's the first sled that has shown the ability to get around number 60. Everyone else can only see
up to date on where they are. Yeah. Looks like the 74 machine has gotten ahead of the 21.
now in sixth place. He bunked on 74 in this test. Watch the drivers as they go through turns one and two, how rough it is over there. I was noticing this is following now.
Pit stops here. Everybody comes in and gets 5 minutes. Thank you. Go, 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 Tim.
Tricky on the 60 machine, trying to get some distance gain back on the field.
To race Monty Tolan hurt, I guess. Don't know how bad.
Sled number 46, our current points leader, when we started this event, has been having a bad day also. They broke a track adjuster, which meant that the weight of the machine was all on the track and that it had no steering. So that's why they've gone from being a contender up there in fourth place and third place at one point, all the way back now into 16th place. And they were really hoping for a third place or better finish today, which would have pretty much assured them as the points championship. But it's not to be for them.
You guys ain't working on them sleds over here, right?
Thank you.
champion. Too close to tell him, just wearing up for the doing the extra figures. Congratulations to all the teams and the drivers out there for doing such a great job.
I think we finished four. The board says.
Congratulations to the 60 team on such a good race. Also the 55 team, those guys stay right there in the top five all day.
Five is an artist, yeah.
21 come from Vikings, they're quite a ways back. They battle their way up through there. Another good run for them. Don't forget, everybody, we got a lot more racing action going on